Today we are going to do the second experiment of meter bridge. The aim of the experiment is to verify the series combination of resistances using meter bridge. The basic principle of this experiment is the Wheatstone bridge principle. Whenever four arms of a Wheatstone bridge are balanced, the galvanometer shows zero or null deflection, that is no current flows through the galvanometer. Now before starting, let me explain the circuit. This is the meter bridge. There is a 1 meter long wire here. There is the resistance box which is providing a known resistance here. This is an unknown resistance wire, and we have another unknown resistance wire of a different length, hence a different value. And we have to find whether these wires, when they are connected in series, they follow the law of combination. What is the law of combination? The law of combination is that when two resistance of individual values are connected in series, the net resistance becomes sum of the individual resistances. Now, the procedure to follow for this experiment is, for R1, call this resistance the R1 resistance. We will take out 1 ohm from the resistance box and try to see that keeping 1 ohm in this arm, R1 in this arm, what is the balance position in this wire. So, first to see whether the connections are exactly correct, we will touch it at the end of the wire. As you can see, there is a deflection, and the other end of the wire shows an opposite deflection. So, the connections are correct. Now what we will do, we will try to move or slide the jockey over this wire so that the deflection comes to zero. So we are bringing the deflection here so that it comes to. So we have got this position where the deflection is coming to be zero. And this zero deflection is obtained at a point here, which will be measured by the scale given to us. This scale will be taken from 0 here, that is the top scale, and this is ending at 44 centimeter. So while writing, we will write for 1 ohm the value of 44 centimeter for R1. So R1, 1 ohm is giving us length 44 centimeter. If you subtract, and 100 minus L will be equal to 56 centimeters. So this is the first reading. For the next reading, second reading, we will remove a 2 ohm resistance from the resistance box. Now the balance point should shift, and we'll again find out what is the balance point for this. So now we have got another reading for this balance point. This is around 58 centimeters. So this is the reading for the second, that is 2 ohm resistor. This is 58 centimeter. 2 ohm resistor gives 58, which is equal to, if you subtract 58 from 100, that is 42. Next, now we remove a 3 ohm. For 3 ohm, I have taken out the 2 ohm and 1 ohm together. If you take it out together, this will give a 3 ohm resistance. Again, I am trying to find out what is the balance point by sliding the jockey, and I find this position here, which is 70 centimeters. So that is the balance point here, and 100 minus L will be 30 centimeters. So we have now all the three readings with us. First reading 44, 56, second reading 58, 42, and the third reading is 70 and 30. After this, we will remove this small wire, and now we will connect the another wire of different resistance, call it R2, in across this. So we will connect it like this. We will follow the same procedure for resistance R2, that is, we will try to find out what is the balance point. And we see that if you just remove 1 ohm from this resistance box, the balance point comes out to be 13.8 cm. This is 13.8 cm for 1 ohm. Now we remove 2 ohm from this resistance box and again try to measure the balance point. So we will get another value of balance point, which is 21 cm. And like this, we can get the balance point for the third ohm also. So like this, we can get balance point for 3 readings again for this resistance. Here, if you get the balance point for the third ohm, then it is 30 cm. In the third step, we have to connect both the resistances in series. Now, how to connect them in series? We have the first corner of the first resistance here like this. Then we join the ends of the second resistance with the first resistance like this and twist it nicely so that there is no loose connection. And then we connect this with the other end. So we have twisted this nicely. This is forming a total resistance wire, and now I am connecting it with the other end. So now these resistances are in series. So this is the series connection of the two resistances. We follow the same procedure with 1, 2 and 3 ohms for finding the balance point now. So let me remove 1 ohm from the resistance box again. Move the key here. So the balance point, if you see, I am showing you how the balance point comes. This is the balance point. It is coming out to be at 12 cm. For 1 ohm, 12 cm. Similarly, I will do this for 2 ohms. I will remove 2 ohms from this resistance box, trying to find the balance point, and this is coming out to be 19.2 cm. So now we have got all the readings with us. Now we have to do the calculation to verify the whether the series resistances rule is followed. Now for this, for resistance R1, we have got 3 values of length L and 300 minus L. Using these L and 100 minus L in the formula X is equal to L minus 100 minus L by L into R, we are getting 3 values of resistances here, 1.27, 1.44 and 1.28. Using these three values, we get a mean for the resistance R1, which is 1.33. Similarly, the second resistance R2 also gives us 3 values of length for null point with 1, 2 and 3 resistances, which are 13.8, 21 and 30. And 100 minus L is 86.2, 79 and 70. Now we have 3 values of resistances here, which can be meaned again and got a value 6.92. Now we know that the resistances are R1 and R2. If we connect them in series, we must get a resistance of R1 plus R2 which is equal to 8.25. This is our real value. Let us check whether we are getting this as the experimental value. Now, once we connect them in series, we again get three readings, 1, 2 and 3 ohm, 12, 19.2 and 24.3. And using these three values, we have got 100 minus L, and using 100 minus L by L into R again, we are getting three values, 7.33, 8.42 and 9.34. And the mean of these give 8.36. So you see that the experimental value is slightly more than the real value, but it is within the experimental error. Hence, we can say that the law of combination of resistances in series is verified by Meter Bridge experiment.